All right, guys, it's time for yet another code challenge to test and see if you've learned what was covered in previous lessons. So head over to the assignment that is day 3.1, odd or even. Have a read of the instructions and try to see if you can create a program that checks whether if a number that you input in the console is odd or even. Now, the thing to remember here though is that we're introducing something called the modulo, and you can create the symbol by simply typing the percentage sign. Now, what the modulo does is it will divide a number, say 7, by another number, let's say 2, and then it'll give you the remainder of that division. So 7 divided by 2, 7 split into portions of 2 is 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1, right? So 7 divided by 2 can be divided 3 times with a remainder of 1. And that's what the modulo gives you. So you can also type code straight into the console, like I am going to do now. 7 modulo 2 gives me 1. Now, it's the same thing if you try to divide by other numbers. Let's say 7 modulo 3. Well, that is 3 plus 3 plus 1, right? So 7 modulo 3 will also give me 1. So this is a way for us to divide a number by another number and get the remainder. And you're going to be using this modulo to solve this code challenge. Have a read of the instructions, have a look at the examples, and see what it is that we're expecting to be printed in the console here. And then go ahead and write your code and see if your output matches what it is that we're expecting. So 56 should be even, so you should be printing this is an even number based on that input. Pause the video now and give this code challenge a go. All right, so I mentioned that the modulo gives us the remainder, right? So what do we know about even numbers? Well, even numbers, they're always divisible by 2. If we pick any even number, say 54, and then we do modulo 2, so 54 divided by 2, it should always give us 0 as long as that first number is even. So 68 modulo 2, again it's 0. But then when we come across an odd number, say 53 modulo 2, then this is now going to give us 1. We can use our code to check for when the result is 0, in which case it's an even number, and when the result is 1, in which case it's an odd number. If you've gotten stuck until this point, then this is a really great time to pause the video again and go back and give it another go. And then we'll go through the solution together. We can simply write an if statement to check if the number that was inputted is divisible by 2 with 0 remainder. Well, in this case, then we can pretty much be sure that this is an even number. Because as we've shown, all the even numbers, when they divide by 2, there's always no remainder. So in this case, let's add a colon. We can print pretty confidently that this is an even number. Now, what about the cases where the number, when divided by 2, is not equal to 0? Well, then it's probably going to be an odd number. So in this case, we can use an else statement to catch that. And when we have an odd number, we'll simply print this is an odd number. So that's it. Just four lines of code using what we've learned about if, else, and also the comparison operator. Now, if you got stuck on this and you needed to watch the solution, then I recommend really going back to your code and playing around with it so that you can get the code to work. And then try and see if you can test if a particular number is cleanly divisible by 3, by 4, by 5, and then see if the final program actually works in the way that you expect it to. But once you're ready, head over to the next lesson where we're going to talk about even more complex ways of using if and else statements. So for all of that and more, I'll see you there.